Hello guys, today's video will be about how to install and how to use the Substance Painter live link with Marmoset Toolbag. So let's get started. Once you download the zip file and extract it, you'll find a folder like this one. To install the plugin, you need to open the Substance Painter folder and copy the HHConnect folder to the Algorithmics plugin path that is usually located in Documents, Algorithmic, Substance Painter, Plugins. After copying the folder, open the license leak file and add your license. Now, when you open Substance Painter, the plugin will be available as you can see here. Inside the folder you downloaded, you will find a folder called Marmoset. Open it and copy all the content. Then open Toolbag, go to the menu Edit, Plugins, Show User Plugin Folder, and Paste. In the same menu, click Refresh. Now you'll be able to see a new plugin called HHConnect. Click it and you'll see this window. That means the plugin was installed correctly. To use the plugin in Substance Painter, first we need to configure it. To do it, we click the plugin icon in Substance Painter and a window will appear. At the top, we have the pin button. If clicked, the window will be always on top of the UI. Now, in software, we choose Marmoset as well as in renderer. Then we have the output path. Here we choose the export path for the maps that will be generated by Substance Painter, the export resolution, the file format. Then we have a couple of options that currently doesn't work with Marmoset, but will be available soon, which are pack textures and UDIMs. So we'll leave them off. Additionally, we can select if we want also to export the mesh that is used in Substance Painter. And finally, we can select the bit depth of the normal, height, and the general bit depth for the rest of the maps. Now, to send the textures to Marmoset, we have two options. Either send all the texture sets or send only the currently active texture set. In this case, I click Send All. Now in Toolbag, sadly the API is not as strong as in other programs, so you will need to do some extra clicks compared to other implementations. Still, I was able to make it a two-click process. First, we need to select the same folder path in which you exported the texture from Painter. Then we have three buttons. Get mats, that will load all the materials in a list, so you can add them one by one if you want, by clicking the button with the plus sign. Load geo, that will import the geo from the Substance project. And load mats, that will add and assign all the materials to the scene as you can see here. Now, if we change anything in Substance Painter and send the textures again, we'll be able to see the updated material in the renderer. Well, that's all for now. If you have any doubts or requests, let me know in the comments or via the Discord server.
Good luck!